एनएसजी की टीम मुंबई में लैंड करती है, आप उस टीम में थे?
यस, व्हेन वी एंटर्ड द ओबराय इट वाज जस्ट दैट कि टेररिस्ट वर लॉबिंग ग्रेनेड्स इनटू दैट सेंट्रल लॉबी.
आपका स्वागत ग्रेनेड से करा गया.
हां, आवर टारगेट इज हियर नाउ. वी हैव एक्चुअली आइडेंटिफाइड द लोकेशन एंड देयर आफ्टर इट वाज जस्ट अ मैटर ऑफ टाइम कि इन व्हिच फ्लोर वी आर एबल टू हिट देम एंड हाउ हार्ड वी कैन हिट देम.
ओके, हम लोग जीत गए. 71 की लड़ाई, एक नया देश बांग्लादेश क्रिएट हो गया सर, और उसमें इंडियन आर्मी का बहुत बड़ा योगदान था सर.
ऑल द आर्म्स एंड सर्विसेज हैव डन अ वंडरफुल जॉब
सर,
बट आर्टिलरी इज अ गॉड ऑफ वॉर
सर.
आर्टिलरी इज समथिंग व्हिच सॉफ्टन्स अप द एनिमी,
यस सर,
एंड ब्रेक्स देयर विल टू फाइट,
यस सर,
थ्रू रूथलेस फायर ऑन देम,
यस सर.
सर, अभी इतनी टेक्नोलॉजी आ गई है, इंडिया स्पेंडिंग मनी ऑल्सो मेकिंग यू नो मिसाइल्स आ गई हैं सर, हमारे पास रॉकेट्स आ गए हैं. तो जो ट्रेडिशनल आर्टिलरी है सर, जो पहले का तोपखाना था, अभी मॉडर्न भी तोपखाना है सर. जैसे बोफोर्स है हमारी गन्स, वो एक ट्रेडिशनल गन हो गई. क्या उसका रोल है जंग में, लड़ाई में, क्या उसका रोल कम हो गया सर, कि हमारे पास अब रॉकेट्स आ गए हैं और हमारे पास यू नो मिसाइल्स आ गई हैं, तो जो तोपें हैं हमारी, तोपों का रोल कम हो गया है, कि आप समझते हैं आज भी तोपों का रोल है और आगे भी रहेगा?
बिल्कुल, मैं बिना किसी हेजिटेशन के मैं इसका जवाब दूंगा कि जो ट्रेडिशनल आर्टिलरी है उसका रोल उतना ही है जितना पहले था, उसमें कोई डायल्यूशन नहीं हुई है. और साथ ही साथ जो है कि जो हमारे पास जो लॉन्ग रेंज जो रॉकेट्स एंड मिसाइल्स हैं उनका अलग से रोल है
जी.
और इस बिकॉज ऑफ दिस हमारी जो है जो आर्टिलरी का जो ताकत है बहुत बढ़ गया है, क्योंकि अभी हम एक ही टाइम पे हम जो पास वाली जो जंग है वो लड़ सकते हैं और उसी टाइम हम पीछे वाली जंग भी लड़ सकते हैं एट द सेम टाइम. तो हर एक आर्टिलरी का अपना अपना रोल है. जो शॉर्ट रेंज आर्टिलरी है या मीडियम रेंज आर्टिलरी है उसका अपना रोल है, और जो लॉन्ग रेंज आर्टिलरी है जो पीछे वार करती है उसका अपना रोल है. इसमें कोई रोल नहीं है, और ट्रेडिशनल आर्टिलरी का रोल वही रहेगा, इसमें कोई चेंज नहीं है.
सर, प्लीज़ टेल अस अबाउट योर डेज एज यंगस्टर, जब आप सेकंड लेफ्टिनेंट थे सर, जब आप आए थे. और मैंने ये भी सुना है कि यू आर फ्रॉम अ फौजी फैमिली सर. कितने जनरेशन से आपके परिवार में फौजी हैं, आपका बेटा भी अभी इंडियन आर्मी में कमीशन हुआ है सर अभी. तो ये क्या स्टोरी है सर आपके फैमिली की, और आपके यंगस्टर डेज की भी कुछ बात बताइए हमें.
गौरव, यू हैव टच्ड अ लॉट ऑफ स्वीट मेमोरीज. सबसे पहले जहाँ तक मेरा सवाल है, मैं आपको ये बताना चाहूँगा कि आई एम अ फिफ्थ जनरेशन आर्मी ऑफिसर, एंड माय यंगर सन हु इज़ नाउ जॉइन द आर्मर्ड कोर, ही विल बिकम अ कैप्टन जस्ट अबाउट 10 डेज टाइम. ही इज़ द सिक्स्थ जनरेशन आर्मी ऑफिसर, एंड आई एम वेरी प्राउड ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट माय सन हैज़ इज़ कैरिंग ऑन द ट्रेडिशंस ऑफ आवर फैमिली. और जो मेरा परिवार था, मेरे जो पिताजी थे वो इन्फेंट्री में थे, वॉज फ्रॉम 3-6. एंड इन फैक्ट आई वुड लाइक टू शो यू दिस. This is my father's baton.
All right, sir.
And if you see over here,
sir,
this is the insignia of
the insignia of the Sikh regiment.
Sikh
sir.
regiment. This is a gunner.
Yes, sir.
And I will hand this over once I retire to my son, so that he can put the armored corps insignia over here.
Sir,
it will become a very nice, nice multicolored baton.
Sir.
But that apart, I would also like to inform you that. जो मेरे जो ग्रैंड फादर्स थे, ग्रेट ग्रैंड फादर्स थे एंड ग्रेट ग्रेट ग्रैंड फादर, दे वर फ्रॉम बेसिकली फ्रॉम द कैवलरी. एंड इन फैक्ट मेरे रिकॉर्ड में एक आई गॉट अ सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ एप्रिसिएशन साइन बाय फील्ड मार्शल ऑकिंडेक व्हेन माय ग्रेट ग्रैंड फादर हैड रिटायर्ड
फ्रॉम सर्विस. क्लॉड ऑकिंडेक,
क्लॉड ऑकिंडेक साइन बाय हिम appreciating his services for the army. That, and as far as my younger days are concerned, I would like to add that I was commissioned in a very old and a very elite unit of the Indian army, that is the 7th Field Regiment Gazala. It's a Second World War vintage unit, and Gazala means that we earned the honor title in the Battle of Bir Hakim, if you recall, where our regiment destroyed 26 Panzer tanks in direct fire engagement, in one engagement. The tanks were raiding the
somewhere in North Africa, sir?
North Africa. the Battle of Bir Hakim, the Battle of Gazala.
Sir, any relation to Field Marshal Rommel, sir? His tanks, because yeah, Panzer Division?
They were his tanks.
His tanks?
His tanks.
Excellent. So, this is truly legendary, sir. Truly legendary.
So, we won that honor title. It's known as 7th Field Regiment Gazala.
Sir.
So, I was fortunate to have been commissioned into such an elite unit.
Sir.
With such elite officers. So, our initial grooming was excellent. And sir, couldn't have asked for anything better.
Yes.
We also owe a lot of our grooming to so many senior elite gunners. You can see many of them on in this archives over here.
Sir.
And we owe everything to them, and that is how life went on, and that is how we've reached over here.
Absolutely, sir. Absolutely.
Okay, Gaurav, let's take the discussion outside.
Absolutely, yeah, sir. So we've heard so much about artillery. You know, kya uski shamta hai, kya salahiyat hai, sir? लेकिन कोई नए वेपन सिस्टम्स भी आ रहे हैं क्या हम लोग कोई नए वेपन सिस्टम्स आर्टिलरी में इंट्रोड्यूस कर रहे हैं सर अभी
यू आर राइट गौरव लॉट ऑफ प्रोग्रेस हैज बीन मेड इन द रीसेंट इयर्स
यस सर
एंड लॉट ऑफ वर्क इज गोइंग ऑन फॉर इंडक्शन ऑफ न्यू वेपन सिस्टम्स
जी
इन द फील्ड ऑफ सर्विलेंस वी हैव ऑलरेडी इंडक्टेड एंड ऑपरेशनलाइज्ड वेपन लोकेटिंग रडार व्हिच इज नोन एज स्वाति
Sir.
It's an indigenous weapon locating
radar. Swati is a weapons locating radar, sir. So somebody's firing, Swati will tell you.
It is meant for CB, the counter bombardment.
Sir.
Very effective radar. It's been operationalized and very nice.
Yes, sir.
It's improved our counter fire capabilities to a very large extent.
Yes, sir.
As far as the gun systems are concerned, wide variety is coming to service. Already sir. In the pipeline, immediate pipeline, we are going to get the ultra light howitzer.
Sir.
You must have heard about it in the media
reports.
Sir,
yes, sir.
All these are 155mm class.
Sir.
So, in fact, soon in School of Artillery, we'll be starting the training on these new weapon systems.
Sir. What is your message, sir? Aapka message kya hai un gentlemen cadets ko? Jinko aap agar wo chahein ki artillery join karna chahein koi aur, to aap unko kya kehna chahenge ki artillery mein kyun aaye ho, sir?
Ji. Artillery jo hai, ek बहुत ही शक्तिशाली आर्म है इट इज़ द आर्म ऑफ द फ्यूचर और मतलब कि हर एक ने इसको एक्नॉलेज किया है कि ये गॉड ऑफ वॉर है
जी.
ये बैटल विनिंग आर्म है ये एक एक तरह का ये डिसाइसिव आर्म है
जी.
और जितने भी आपके जो फ्यूचर जो कॉन्फ्लिक्ट्स होंगे
जी.
जो जिसका नेचर आ रहा है
जी.
आर्टिलरी एक ऐसा आर्म है जो स्ट्रेटेजिक ऑपरेशनल और टैक्टिकल हर स्फेयर में जो है इसका जो है काम एक साथ ही चलता है ऐसी आम आई थिंक आपको और कहीं नहीं मिलेगी
जी.
जिस तरह से जो नया इक्विपमेंट आ रहा है जो गन्स आ रहे हैं जो पोर्टेंट वेपन सिस्टम्स आ रहे हैं रडार्स आ रहे हैं रॉकेट्स आ रहे हैं मिसाइल्स आ रहे हैं इसमें इतना स्कोप है ऑफ फर्दर यू नो मॉडर्नाइजेशन एंड फर्दर एम्प्लॉयमेंट जो कि जो हमारी जो यंग जनरेशन है उनको ऑटोमेटिकली उनको मोटिवेट होना चाहिए कि ये जो है आर्म ऑफ द फ्यूचर है
जी
हंस उनको ये जो है ज्वाइन करना चाहिए
थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर जॉइनिंग अस
थैंक यू वेरी मच गौरव
सच एन ऑनर एंड प्लेजर सर
सो नाइस मीटिंग यू
थैंक यू सर Viewers, I'm at the Artillery Museum here in Devlali and I'm informed that inside these gates is hundreds of years of history of the Regiment of Artillery, pre-independence, post-independence, a saga of valor, grit, sacrifice and courage. Come with me as I take you to perhaps your most interesting history lesson. Artillery, the god of war. Viewers, I have a special guest here with me today who is along with me going to show you the museum and all the history of the Regiment of Artillery of the Indian Army. It's my honor and privilege to present to you Colonel S.R. Sriram. Sir,
Hi.
Welcome to Patriot,
Hi,
sir.
How are you?
I'm good, sir. How are you, sir?
Hi, thank you.
So, sir, let's go and see your museum, sir.
Yeah. Gaurav, I would like to... This is our foray
All right.
to start with. Okay, here, the valor, of Havaldar, Honorary Captain Umrao Singh, who earned Victoria Cross
Sir.
In the Burma campaign,
Sir.
Wherein in Kaladan Valley, he was instrumental in beating back the Japanese attack.
Sir.
When he's completed the ammunition,
Sir.
Then he used the
gun rammer, Sir.
Gun rammer.
Sir.
And then he inflicted casualties on 10 Japanese soldiers.
Viewers, a gun rammer is like a long rod. Sir, metal ka hai?
It's of metal.
Metal rod, heavy metal rod?
Heavy metal rod.
He took a heavy metal rod, and with that metal rod, he was alone because all his comrades
rest of the
died.
Gun crew.
The rest of the crew was
injured.
No more. They had fallen in battle. And Havaldar Umrao Singh, later honorary captain, ye akele the. Inhone gun rammer liya, jo ek metal ka bahut bada rod hota hai, jo ki gun ko fire karne mein istemal kara jata hai. Usko leke inhone kai Japanese ko maar dala wahan pe. Aur jab ye baad mein paaye gaye wahan pe, behoshi ki halat mein paaye gaye, to inke aas paas dher sare Japanese मरे पड़े या इंजर्ड वहाँ पे दिखाई दिए. इस बहादुरी के लिए उनको विक्टोरिया क्रॉस मिला, जो कि इंडिपेंडेंस से पहले, आज़ादी के पहले सबसे, मतलब इससे ऊंचा, और जैसे हमारे अब हम परमवीर चक्र कहते हैं सर, उस टाइम पे विक्टोरिया क्रॉस हुआ करता था सर, इससे ऊंचा कोई भी अवार्ड नहीं था. दैट इज़ द लेजेंड ऑफ हवलदार उमराव सिंह, लेटर ऑनरी कैप्टन सर.
हियर इज लेफ्टिनेंट कर्नल श्रीराम कुमार.
एट दैट टाइम
हु इज द वन, एट द टाइम ही वाज द मेजर
श्रीराम.
He was from artillery. He is from artillery,
yes,
and
sir.
He got the highest peacetime gallantry award of Ashok Chakra,
yes,
for his valor in neutralizing the terrorists in Imphal.
Yes, sir. He was very low-key. He is a living Ashok Chakra.
Living Ashok Chakra,
which is itself, sir, a living legend. Sir, बहुत बड़ी बात है. It's a very big thing, sir. To be a living Ashok Chakra.
Yes.
But when I spoke to him and I said that, you know, Colonel Shriram, you know, what a fantastic thing that you have done and all. And he was very downplayed about it. I said, that is also a creed of the soldier, sir.
Yes.
You play up your unit's achievements and the achievements of your own brothers.
Yes.
But your own achievements, you sort of downplay.
Yes.
Four terrorists were neutralized in this very brilliant action in the Northeast, specifically in Manipur, Colonel Shriram. At that time, he was
a major.
And he got the Ashok Chakra, which is the highest peacetime gallantry award in India.
I've often wondered, sir, after I saw the Pakistani being hammered in Kargil by Bofors, I have always thought, what must it be like to be at the target end of artillery shelling, sir? What would it be like, sir, to be at the target end, sir?
It is, in fact, that much, that heavy volume of fire,
yes, sir.
When it comes unannounced,
yes.
Then you can imagine the amount of the TNT and the shrapnels which fly. And causes the destruction,
yes,
at the target.
Yes, sir.
So somebody described it as it's like 100 express trains are screaming at you at one time.
Yes.
And they said that out of the 100 and something survivors, I think 14 or 17 had gone mad because, you know, it's crazy, sir, artillery fire.
Yes.
And what do we have here, sir?
And this is the evolution of the
artillery.
Guns.
Okay.
Of the artillery.
Yes.
To start with, it started as a catapult.
Okay.
Very simple, this one. And then it graduated once the gunpowder got invented,
sir.
Discovered. Then the French, they used this particular pot de fer, wherein they used to fill this particular pot with the gunpowder
and light
it from the top.
And this arrow,
and this shrapnel used to go and cause the destruction at the target.
The arrow, sir, it would.
Yeah, these were earlier cannons,
sir.
Wherein the major requirement was to breach through the fort wall and enter the fort.
So they would fire it from a short distance, sir?
Short distance.
Not very.
The ranges were hardly.
Because barrel is only this much, sir.
Yes.
So what can be the range?
The ranges were only 800 meters to 1 kilometer.
1 kilometer.
And slowly it has evolved to the Mughal artillery.
This is the Mughal brass cannon, sir.
Yes, this is the Mughal brass cannon.
Original.
Yes.
Mughal brass cannon.
Yes.
From the Mughal times.
And this is Maratha artillery. Wherein his main tactics were the guerrilla warfare.
Yes.
So there, if you see their artillery,
sir.
It's very light.
Light.
Because they had to
carry it.
Carry
through
it
the
and
mountains,
move.
Through the jungles, sir.
Through the jungles, and
yes,
they
sir.
Had to move. So slowly, if you see over the ages,
yes,
the improvement has come in.
Yes.
And the Sikh artillery, Maharaja Ranjit Singh.
Maharaja Ranjit Singh's forces, sir.
Yes. They had sizable artillery pieces.
In fact, sir, Maharaja Ranjit Singh had hired. I read history that he had hired a lot of European experts.
Yes.
And he, Maharaja Ranjit Singh, was a thinking general in the sense that he said that wherever I can get excellence from, I will take it, irrespective of nationality. So a lot of Europeans in his court who would say, sir, you know, we'll make something like this and all these Maharaja Ranjit Singhs.
Yeah. Then this is Tipu Sultan, way back, like what we have today, multi-barrel rocket launcher. He was the first, the credit in fact goes to his era.
Yes, sir.
Wherein this particular Ratan Ban,
yes, sir,
which had 102 barrels,
yes,
was used in the Battle of Srirangapatnam.
Yes, sir.
He effectively used, and from this, the modern days MVRL have evolved. Mainly it was drawn by horses, so that the mobility aspect was also taken care of. So this is a mountain artillery gun, 75-24mm howitzer. It was in use before, in the 80s and 90s, it was in great use.
Yes. So this gun you must have seen in your service also, sir, I think.
Yes.
You've seen this
it
gun?
It was my first unit into which I got commissioned. I had this particular equipment.
You had this?
Yes,
particular gun, sir. Good gun, sir?
A very good gun, which had a range of 11 kilometers.
Sir.
Very effective in the mountains because it could fire in high angle.
Also at an emotional level, so you were connected because this was the first gun, sir.
Yes, and also this could be dropped by heli also.
Heli also. Oh, it's a light gun, sir.
Yes.
I'm sure it can drop by heli.
And this is a 3-inch rocket projector,
sir,
which had multi-barrels.
This is the old MBRL.
Yes.
So-called, sir.
Yeah.
400 angle.
Yes. And as you know, Gaurav, earlier,
yes, sir,
the Army Air Defense,
sir,
and the today, present day Army Aviation,
yes,
was part of the artillery.
Artillery, sir.
Army Air Defense was part of artillery till as late as 1996.
Sir.
And the aviation,
sir,
which was earlier known as AeroP,
yes,
was there with us, part of artillery till 1986. This segment showcases the artillery during various dynasties.
Okay, sir.
Like this is during the Mughal period.
The ordnance carries two identical lines on its back. This is again a Mughal gun, sir. Zafar Baksh, 1674, Aurangzeb.
At the time, most of the guns, they were being manufactured in Murshidabad area of the Bengal.
Yes, sir.
This is of the Bengal
artillery, guns of Bidar. Guns of Bijapur.
Guns of Bijapur, guns of Jats, and this is the artillery of Sindhias.
Sindhias of Gwalior, sir?
Yes. And the guns of Karnataka.
Karnataka, guns of Jammu and Kashmir.
Jammu and Kashmir.
The Dogra guns, sir?
Yes.
The Chitral victory gun.
Then this is the artillery of Rajputs. This is what we have seen in the evolution of artillery gallery. This is Maratha artillery pieces.
Maratha artillery pieces.
That belongs to the Maratha artillery.
This is such a lovely story, sir. The mule Kandahar. This mule served for a very long time, and viewers, just see this. These are icons, you know, just a mule, okay? For some of you, just an animal. But it must have participated in so many battles, fought so many wars, helped so many soldiers, carried and ferried so much ammunition. And this mule is entitled to wear the ribbons of the following medals on the brow band of the parade head collar: Afghan War, Kandahar Star, Old Frontier, New Frontier, Long and Distinguished Service, and Delhi Darbar, 1911.
These are our brave soldiers who have laid down their lives.
Yes, sir.
Their names are here on the roll of honor board in various operations.
Op Rhino, Op Falcon.
Yes.
Op Parakram. Op Parakram was after the Parliament attacks when we mobilized. Simply during mobilization, you know. So furious was the mobilization, we. Indo-Pak War, 1971, Zile Singh, S.N. Krishnan, Narang Singh, Gunner Gurbet Singh, Major V.P. Khatri, Major A.G. Khare, Lance Nayak, Chalappan Nair, hundreds upon hundreds of gunners.
Yeah, we constantly update on a regular basis.
Sir, because this is something that you hear about every day. Yaap har roz inki kahaniyan sunte hain, har roz raat ko jab aap ghar aate hain kaam karke. Operation Rakshak, जम्मू एंड कश्मीर. लोग पूछते हैं कि फौज शांति काल में करती क्या है. What does the army do in peace time? This is what the army does in peace time. ये देखें, कतारें हैं, कतारों के ऊपर कतारें, उनके ऊपर कतारें लगातार. I often tell people, they ask what is this, and I say again and again, this is the price of our freedom. If you see this, you know, this is the pistol that this Pakistani general surrendered to
B. Gonzalez, no, war is hell in all its forms. I don't know what was the occasion in which the Pakistani general was smiling. You know, he seems to be smiling merrily, handing over his pistol. I don't, you know, we suffered very serious reverses in the 1962 war against the Chinese. Very serious reverses. There is no shame in saying that we lost that war to Chinese. But I would challenge anybody to find one example of an Indian general giving his pistol to a Chinese general. An Indian army officer or jawan would rather die than surrender. You know, no retreat, no surrender. This is a memory, not just a victory for the Indians. It is also a memory of eternal shame for the Pakistanis. This hall is full of sacrifices of the Regiment of Artillery. Every square foot of this hall reminds you of the sacrifices from olden times till today. You know, for centuries, gunners have been shedding their blood. There isn't a single battlefield where the gunners have not sacrificed and the gunners have not struck terror into the hearts of the enemy. Sir, thank you very much for being on Patriot and speaking to us. It was an honor and a pleasure, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, brother.
Viewers, I'm here at an Indian Army facility in Nasik, and behind me is the Searcher Mark 1 UAV. UAV is something that you know as the drone. It's going to fly. It has a range of 100 kilometers. This is now on a training sortie. It'll go up, up, up and away, thousands of feet in the air. It's going to take photographs and stream those photographs to a facility close by that is going to then process those images. Viewers, you've just seen the magnificent flight of this drone. I'm with the surveillance and target acquisition team here somewhere in Nasik, and with me I have a very special guest. Honored to present to you Brigadier Gopi Iyer. Sir, welcome to Patriot, sir.
Hi, Gaurav.
Sir, we've seen the wonderful flight of this drone. Why do we need drones in the Indian Army?
In order to look beyond the horizon,
sir,
we need an asset,
sir,
which can act as an aerial platform,
yes,
and look deep into enemy territory.
Sir.
The UAVs perform this role.
Yes, sir.
They fly deep into enemy territory,
sir,
and then they provide surveillance,
yes,
and they also acquire targets.
Sir.
A real-time downlink passes this data to us,
yes, sir,
and then we ensure sensor-shooter integration,
okay,
and ensure these acquired targets of the enemy are engaged and neutralized, thus facilitating the war effort.
Basically, sir, you're saying eye in the sky, sir.
Absolutely correct.
And more than eye in the sky.
More than eye in the sky.
An intelligent eye in the sky, sir.
Absolutely correct.
And sir, what this drone capabilities, whatever I could read on the internet, is approximately 100 kilometers.
Absolutely.
This is an old drone, sir.
Yes.
And there are many new drones which have come, which have far, far more capability than this one.
Yes, absolutely.
And maybe in terms of kilometers, maybe in terms of staying up in the air for more than 24 hours. So currently, do we have those capabilities?
Yes, we have the capabilities. We have got in our inventory,
yes,
such remotely piloted aircraft system,
yes,
which have got endurance in excess of 24 hours.
Yes, sir.
And with the new SATCOMs coming in,
yes,
they will have range in approximately 1,000 kilometers.
Sir.
And they will have multiple payloads.
Sir.
That means they will have cameras which can carry out surveillance both by day and night.
Right,
and payloads, electromagnetic and electro-optical.
Sir.
So they will fulfill the requirements of surveillance and target acquisition.
Right, sir. So let's say, sir, this is a searcher. And let's say I am a UAV pilot, sir, and I have to convert to a Heron, for example, sir. So I need to go through conversion training.
Absolutely. The basics are all taught here.
Yes.
You're already a pilot here.
Yes, sir.
Thereafter, you go to a Heron unit.
Okay.
There's a procedure laid down for conversion into an Heron aircraft.
Okay.
That takes about 3 to 4 weeks.
Sir.
And under a qualified flying instructor, you train. And thereafter, you're operational.
Operational, sir. And we look forward to more drones, sir. We keep on hearing media reports of armed drones and better drones coming. Hopefully in the future, sir, we'll have better capabilities.
Hopefully we should be having that.
Absolutely, sir. Thank you very much for talking to Patriot, sir.
It was a pleasure.
It's my honor and privilege to present to you Lieutenant Colonel Adgaonkar.
Hi, Gaurav.
Hello, Chief Instructor and Test Pilot. So tell us, Colonel, how, and I'm going to ask you a very, very basic generic question. How difficult is it to fly this bird?
Gaurav, let me put it across in simple terms. If you have passion to fly, it's very easy. If you have in it you, you can do anything with this aircraft. Otherwise, you'll keep learning and you'll never be able to fly it as it is supposed to fly.
Okay, like you were saying, your imagination is your limit.
Correct.
You mentioned this a little while back.
Yes, you can do wonders with this aircraft.
Yes.
Use it for various roles, provided you think about it and you exploit it in the manner you want.
Now, I saw you sitting down in a chair and you had some sort of a remote control in your hand and you were piloting the aircraft. Now, to anybody else, an untrained eye, a civilian, he would think this is like Xbox or a video game.
Correct.
But this is the Indian Army, right?
Correct.
And we're in the business of life and death.
Yes, yes.
So this is not Xbox.
This is
what is it?
It's nowhere an Xbox. It's number of hours of hard work, perseverance, and in the sun standing and practicing on aero models, 100 hours of aero models, 25 hours of half scale models, which you have seen. It is the absolute half scale of this model. So after graduating, getting solo on those aircraft, practicing emergencies on aerobatic models, then only you graduate to day and night flying on this aircraft. Whether it's a Heron class or a Searcher class, immaterial of this, the training remains the same. It is hard work, 6 months of hard work, which goes into external pilot's training. What you saw was an external pilot who was flying from the remote control that is called the box or a RC or a Xbox in your parlance.
Yes.
There are other two streams which are more important, that is internal pilot, who is sitting inside the ground control station and controlling the aircraft all throughout the mission. He is responsible for the emergencies and handle the aircraft all throughout the mission area, supporting the observer, who is a third category, who's controlling the payload. So observer controls the payload, the internal pilot controls the aircraft, and the external pilot's job is to take off and land, handling emergencies manually.
Okay.
So this is, in short,
absolutely
three categories.
Absolutely. So this Colonel Adgaonkar is essentially the training piece.
Correct.
Now the operational piece.
Correct.
This bird has the ability to fly at least 100 kilometers.
Yep.
And as Brigadier Gopi Iyer told us, we have UAVs or such birds which can fly over 1,000 kilometers, stay more than 24 hours in the air.
Absolutely.
This is basically for training purpose here?
Yes. This is a basic aircraft, Searcher Mark 1, which is very, very basic aircraft procured in 1998. Now there are much better class of UAVs which we are operationally utilizing in the field formations, that is in Leh, Manasbal and other areas.
Yes.
So this is just for training for students who come as a basic pilot. Thereafter they graduate, as Brigadier Gopi Iyer would have told you, they graduate into a full-scale Heron or something in their particular base, in the op bases, and they get converted accordingly.
Okay. Colonel Adgaonkar, thank you for speaking.
Thank you,
Gaurav. It was
so nice.
Indeed, a pleasure.
Yeah.
Viewers, you just saw the 105mm gun go off just behind my head, and I have a special guest with me today. His name is Major Dinesh Chahar, and he is a paratrooper. Now, a paratrooper in artillery, what is the role of a paratrooper in artillery? Why do we need paratroopers in artillery? I'm going to speak to the Major, and he will tell us and he will educate us. Major Chahar, welcome to Patriot.
Hi, Major Gaurav.
Now, tell us, first of all, about the paratrooper wings and also about the maroon beret that you're wearing. Why do you need paratroopers in the artillery?
So, as a matter of fact, a paratrooper is required for all kinds of operation and all kinds of arms. It's a paratrooper complement is not even for artillery. It is for infantry as well as for supply. It's there's a paramedic also. There's a para supply guys also.
Okay.
So a paratrooper, by definition, is a combat soldier which is capable of jumping behind the enemy lines and operating for quite some duration of time in an isolated battlefield. without any guidance.
All right. So, you're from the artillery regiment.
Yes.
Now, you're a paratrooper.
Yes.
So, typically in your unit, which will be entirely full of paratroopers, what will be the role of an officer like you? What would you do generally, or what would the unit's role be?
So, a parafield regiment is a, you know, is a strategic asset with any kind of army, which is capable of dropping itself behind enemy lines as and when the war bugle goes off, and it is capable of operating behind enemy lines for 24 to 48 hours duration, independent on its own. You know, it can pose a threat inside the enemy to its strategic and tactical targets deep inside its enemy target.
Which means, Major Char, that not only will you jump from planes, yeah, aapke guns one sab leke jump
karte. Yes, definitely. So the full complement, along with the officers, yes, the men, the JCOs, and the guns which you see behind them,
all
they are
weapons,
capable of dropping everything on ground inside enemy territory and then operating from there.
So jab jaise gun hum log ये पूरी गन है जो जिसको जब हम एयरक्राफ्ट से नीचे ड्रॉप करते होंगे तो इसमें भी अलग टेक्निकलिटीज होती होंगी ना. बिल्कुल.
यस सर, बिल्कुल.
पैराशूट है इसके और 10 किस्म की अलग चीजें होती हैं.
ये जो गन है जो आप अपने देख रहे हैं, इसका टोटल वेट है 2275 केजी. सो दैट्स अ ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑफ वेट. सो इट रिक्वायर्स ऑलमोस्ट 4 मेन पैराशूट्स, 1 ऑक्सिलरी एंड 1 एक्सट्रैक्टर. दैट मींस 6 पैराशूट्स आर रिक्वायर्ड ऑन वंस इट इज पैक्ड कंप्लीटली एंड लोडेड ऑनटू अ प्लेटफॉर्म स्टफ्ड इनसाइड एन एयरक्राफ्ट.
All right.
So thereafter, when it goes up in the aircraft, goes up in the air inside the enemy territory, it is just pushed outside the aircraft, and the gun, the parachutes deploy, the gun comes down on the ground, the gunners, we jump out of the aircraft sometimes after that, and then we get these guns into action along with the ammunition.
So tell me, Major, probation hua tha?
Yes.
Kya sa tha probation? Tough?
I can't actually call the probation tough. Actually, it's the thing that makes it tough is the unpredictability. You never know, what is going to happen. Agle minute kya hoga, agle ghante kya hoga, or what is going to come up.
Aur agle din ka sochte bhi nahi hai.
Agle din ka, to it's a very very far off thing.
Yes.
You just live by the minute, and you give your best at that particular time.
Achha.
So that unpredictability makes it all the more tougher.
Tougher.
Yeah.
Major Char, it was wonderful speaking to you.
Thank you so
Thank
much.
Thank you so very much.
Thank you.
Such a pleasure. अगर मैं आपसे पूछूंगा एयरफोर्स अच्छी और आर्मी, तो घर में लड़ाई हो जाएगी ना?
Yeah, definitely. But I am an officer first, so I will always say that Air Force is the best.
Well said. We respect you for that, ma'am. Well said. Viewers, I'm here at the artillery school mess with a particular thought in my mind. What happens when a soldier goes to the front? What happens when an officer goes to fight along the line of control? Counterinsurgency operations, Siachen Glacier, the Northeast. The country is riddled with problems, and it seems that only soldiers can solve them. But who looks after the home and hearth when the soldier is out? Today, it's my proud privilege and honor to introduce to you wives of officers of artillery who are posted here at Devlali, and they will share their experiences with you about army, the Indian army as a family, and this unique bond of sisterhood that exists. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening. I'm Squad Leader Gayatri.
All right. And you're posted here?
I'm posted to Air Force Station Devlali.
Excellent. So how's life been in Devlali for you?
Life in Devlali is really beautiful. You must have seen the scenery over here. Place-wise, Devlali is a beautiful place. And other than that, professionally also, I think I am at the right place.
Absolutely. And ma'am, do you happen to be married to an artillery officer?
Yes, I am.
Excellent. Excellent. Boy, I was saying that Air Force and Army, how good friends have become now. Very good, ma'am. Excellent. Excellent. And how many years have you been married?
It's been 5 years.
अच्छा, मैम एक बात बताइए, अगर मैं आपसे पूछूंगा एयरफोर्स अच्छी और आर्मी, तो घर में लड़ाई हो जाएगी ना?
Yeah, definitely.
तो वो सवाल मैं आपसे नहीं पूछूंगा.
But I am an officer first, so I will always say that Air Force is the best.
Well said, and we respect you for that, ma'am. Well said. हाँ, ये only a soldier can say this. Very well said, ma'am. Excellent. और बताइए ma'am, challenges क्या क्या होते हैं? You are an officer, your husband is an officer. How do you balance?
I don't think it's an impossible one. If you have a confidence in you, and if you think that you can do it, that self-determination if you have, I don't think it's an impossible role.
So ma'am, excellent. I didn't know you were an Air Force officer. But achha laga milke aapse. Thank you so much for talking
Same
to us,
here.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Thank you. Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening. I'm Captain Shelley.
Ji.
And it's been 2 years that we are married.
Okay.
और दिस ये पहली बार है कि हम लोग साथ में रह रहे हैं
अच्छा दिस आई वांट टू नो अबाउट इसके पहली पोस्टिंग कहाँ पे थी
मैं एनडीए में पोस्टेड थी खड़कवासला
अच्छा
एंड मेरे हस्बैंड पोस्टेड थे जोधपुर में देन वहाँ से उनकी पोस्टिंग एसएफएफ आ गई नाउ अभी ही इज हियर फॉर द कोर्स
अच्छा सो यू आर गोइंग टू बी हियर फॉर सम टाइम
आई हैव जॉइंड हिम हियर
आई
गॉट माय स्पाउस पोस्टिंग हियर
ओके And you are actually in the army?
Yes, I'm a nursing officer.
All right. So, आप एक बात बताइए फिर आपको दो साल हो गए दो साल में आपने दो या तीन stations तो देखी लिए
हाँ
करीब आगे आपको क्या लगता है अगर आपको नहीं posting मिली जहाँ पे आपके husband है जरूरी नहीं है कि army वहीं पे posting दे जहाँ पे आपके husband है फिर क्या होगा
अगर husband साथ में नहीं भी होते तब भी parents in laws they are there to look after us but जो separation होता है As all said, that separation मतलब वो इतना बना देता है कि now कब husband आएंगे वो सोच के कि हम वो वाला जो moment होगा उसको मतलब अच्छे से everlasting मतलब cherish करते हैं We enjoy that time to the fullest.
Hope you have an interesting life. अभी भी काफ़ी interesting है आपने जो बताई है This is almost like a movie ना But hope you have an interesting life ma'am and all the very best.
Thank you.
Good evening ma'am.
Good evening. I'm Bhavna.
Right.
And हमारी शादी के 14 years हो गए हैं आई एम ऑल्सो अ फौजी ब्रैट माई फादर वॉज अ कुमाऊनी ऑफिसर और इट्स लाइक क्रेडल टू
टिल कुमाऊनी गुड 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 व्हिच कुमाऊ मैम
ही वाज इन थ्री कुमाऊ
राइफल्स
और काफ़ी एक्सपीरियंस है मैंने तो बचपन से लेके अब तक कोई वर्ल्ड अगर देखा है तो वो आर्मी का ही वर्ल्ड है
जी
और When I was a young girl, there was a point when I thought कि अब इतना आर्मी में जब ग्रूम अप होके बड़े हो गए हैं तो शादी एक फौजी से नहीं करेंगे बट जो पसंद आया वो एक गनर ही निकला और आई एम नेवर रिग्रेटेड लाइफ हैज बीन रियली गुड
एक्सेलेंट थैंक यू मैम सच अ प्लेजर टॉकिंग टू यू गुड इवनिंग मैम
गुड इवनिंग आई एम नीति
ओके
एंड आई हैव बीन मैरिड फॉर 15 इयर्स
अच्छा 15 इयर्स में मैम क्या क्या देखा आपने
बहुत कुछ देखा बहुत कुछ देखा बहुत अच्छे अच्छे लोग देखे
जी.
बहुत नई नई जगहें देखी जिनका नाम नहीं सुना था जी. जब पहली बार नाम सुनते थे तो ये लगता था मैप में देखें ये जगह है कहाँ एंड यू वोंट बिलीव वो जगह मिलती नहीं थी कि वो जगह है कहाँ
तो मैम कहाँ पोस्टिंग रही मम्मी बताइए दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग फॉर अस
फिर शुरू हुआ इलाहाबाद से देन ही गॉट पोस्टेड टू JNK JNK में रहे एंड वी केम बैक टू मेरठ आफ्टर दैट Again, he got posted to RR. Then I stayed in SF. और वो जो SF का एक experience था मैं कहूँगी मेरी life का सबसे अच्छा experience था Unit ladies ने जो care करी और as a child, they accept you. ऐसी आपकी देखभाल होती है My daughter was 1.5 years old that time. और बहुत frequently वो बीमार पड़ती थी She has bronchial asthma. कोई ऐसा नहीं होता था कि मैं एक call करूँ और तुरंत आ ना जाए मुझे डॉक्टर के पास लेके जाना दे यूज टू इंश्योर दैट आई वॉज वेल टेकन केयर ऑफ
बिल्कुल मैम और एक और चीज़ है ना मैम कि जो आपने एक्सेप्टेंस की बात करी मोर देन द एक्सेप्टेंस इट इज ऑल्सो दैट फीलिंग ऑफ सिक्योरिटी विच यू कैन ट्रस्ट ब्लाइंड फोल्डेड
एग्जैक्टली
विथ योर आईज क्लोज्ड इन द डार्क यू नो दैट हाँ वी आर इन द इंडियन आर्मी यहाँ कुछ गलत नहीं होगा गलत हो नहीं सकता That kind of trust
बिल्कुल
and
बिल्कुल वो वाली चीज़ है आज मेरी बेटी अगर बाहर वॉक भी कर रही है
जी.
तो मुझे डर नहीं लगता है
जी.
मुझे मालूम है शी इज सेफ
जी
इनसाइड द कैंट शी इज सेफ
यस थैंक यू फॉर टॉकिंग टू अस मैम
थैंक यू
हेलो मैम गुड इवनिंग
आई एम शानू
ओके
आई हैव बीन मैरिड फॉर ऑलमोस्ट 4 years ज़्यादा स्टेशंस तो नहीं देखे
जी
बट काफ़ी कुछ देखा और काफ़ी कुछ सीखा और बहुत अच्छे एक्सपीरियंस है
अच्छा मैम
जब हमारी शादी हुई My husband was instructor in IMA.
जी
तो
तभी आपने ज़्यादा stations नहीं देखे क्योंकि ऑलरेडी देहरादून में there is an instructor. जी बताइए
जी
बताइए
मैं एक सिविलियन बैकग्राउंड से आती हूँ जहाँ दूर दूर तक आपका कोई रिश्तेदार आर्मी में नहीं होता
जी
तो उससे आप पता चलता है कि जो बाहर वाले बैठ के सोच रहे होते हैं आर्मी के बारे में और जो रियलिटी होती है वो कितनी अलग होती है
अलग होती है
आपको सच्चाई सारे चैलेंजेस हर्डल्स तब पता चलते हैं जब आप आर्मी का एक पार्ट बन जाते हैं
जी
मैंने GCs की ट्रेनिंग देखी है उनके चैलेंजेस देखे हैं उसको देखने के बाद मुझे फील हुआ कि इतना कुछ करना पड़ता है एक ऑफिसर बनने के लिए
जी।
प्यार तो था ही शादी में, रिस्पेक्ट और बढ़ गया
जी।
मैंने शादी को 4 साल भी नहीं हुए और मैंने सिर्फ अभी पीच पोस्टिंग्स ही देखी हैं
जी।
मैंने काफ़ी कुछ सीखा है एंड आई हैव ग्रोन एज अ पर्सन
जी।
मैं मेंटली फिजिकली भी स्ट्रांग हुई हूँ
जी।
और मैं मतलब नोटिस कर रही हूँ कि मेरे अंदर काफ़ी इम्प्रूवमेंट्स आ रहे हैं एंड देयर चांसेस कि मैं और कुछ सीखूंगी और इम्प्रूव हो जाऊंगी।
एब्सोल्युटली मैम, थैंक यू सो मच, बहुत अच्छा लगा आपसे बात करके। गुड इवनिंग मैम।
गुड इवनिंग, आई एम मानसूम हजारिका ग्रेवल।
ओके।
एंड बाय प्रोफेशन आई एम अ मैनेजर इन अ स्पोर्ट्स पीआर फर्म।
ओके।
एंड आई हैव बीन मैरिड जस्ट फॉर 2 months नाउ।
डू यू हैव अ फौजी बैकग्राउंड
और नो? कंप्लीटली सिविलियन बैकग्राउंड।
कंप्लीटली सिविलियन बैकग्राउंड। तो आपको लग कैसा रहा? कैसा, अच्छा लग रहा है? इट्स गुड,
इट्स रियली नाइस। दैट्स अ डिफरेंट फीलिंग, वो अलग ही एक फीलिंग आती है जो आप फौजी की वाइफ होते हो। जैसे जितने मेरे फ्रेंड्स हैं सारे सिविलियन बैकग्राउंड से, नोबडी इज मैरिड टू एनी आर्मी ऑफिसर और एनीवन। जब बोलती हूँ कि वो एक आर्मी ऑफिसर है तो अलग से रिस्पेक्ट आता है उनसे भी
जी।
तो वो अलग फीलिंग होती है विच आई डोंट थिंक वी कैन एक्सप्लेन इन वर्ड्स। तो दैट्स कम्प्लीटली आई मीन डिफरेंट एक्सपीरियंस।
एक्सलेंट मैम, थैंक यू, प्लेजर टॉकिंग टू यू। गुड इवनिंग मैम।
गुड इवनिंग, आई एम विद डॉक्टर मिताली एंड मेरे फादर भी फौज में थे, मैं मैरिड टू फौजी हूँ एंड माय सन इज आल्सो इन आर्मी।
क्या बात है।
सो ग्रेट जर्नी और लगता है इससे बेहतर और इससे बढ़िया जिंदगी कोई नहीं हो सकती है।
अच्छा, ऐसा क्यों कह रही हैं मैम कि इससे अच्छी जिंदगी नहीं हो सकती?
हो सकती, बिकॉज 25 साल हो गए मुझे
जी
एंड बचपन में भी मैंने यही जिंदगी देखी है एंड आई फील जो चैलेंजेस जो हमने देखे हैं, जो बॉन होमी, कमराडरी, अडेप्टबिलिटी एंड डिसिप्लिन, लिस्ट इज एंडलेस। वो सब चीज़ें आपको फौज में ही दिखती है और कहीं नहीं दिखती है
जी।
एंड ये सब चीज़ें से पर्सन एक बहुत ही बेटर ह्यूमन बींग ग्रो करता है। इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू ग्रो एज अ ह्यूमन बींग।
थैंक यू वेरी मच मैम, सच अ प्लेजर टॉकिंग टू यू।
सेम, थैंक यू।
लवली, थैंक यू फॉर स्पीकिंग टू अस एंड आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक ऑल द लेडीज हियर।
The place where we are standing here depicts the battle zone of Second World War. The date goes back to 15 December 1944. The place of Kaladan Valley in Burma, now Myanmar. The British Army was advancing and the advance was being supported by Havaldar Umrao Singh's gun position.
All right.
So during the advance, the Japanese Army continued bombardment on the gun position for 90 minutes.
All right.
Immediately after the bombardment, the first wave of attack came towards Havaldar Umrao Singh's gun position.
Obviously, they started attacking.
They started attacking.
Their RT lifted, they started attacking.
They started attacking.
All right.
First wave rippled back.
Okay.
Second wave of attack again rippled back. Third wave of attack again rippled back. One gun position being attacked thrice by 2 company worth troops.
Yes.
However, at the end of the third wave attack, the only remnants were Havaldar Umrao Singh and 2 more gunners. All were critically injured. Umrao Singh himself were injured by 2 hand grenades which just burst next to him.
Okay.
Finally, when the fourth wave attacked, the only thing they left with was courage. No ammunition to fire it.
Ammunition finished?
Ammunition finished. The raw courage, the only thing they left with.
Okay.
So Umrao Singh, what he does, he picks up a handspike. It's a kind of a iron rod. What
big,
you,
big iron
big
rod.
Big iron rod, what you use to lift the guns.
Yes.
He picks it up, marches towards the Japanese attacking enemy.
So this rod is made of metal or wood?
This rod is metal of metal, iron metal. It's pure iron rod.
Pure iron rod and very heavy.
It's heavy rod.
Yes.
He picks it up.
Yes.
Since he doesn't have any ammunition, he marches towards the attacking Japanese army.
So he's surrounded by Japanese. Havaldar Umrao Singh just has one iron rod.
One iron rod.
And here are Japanese with guns and everything.
Two companies attacking.
Two companies attacking. Okay.
So he charges for hand-to-hand combat.
Okay.
Thereafter, after 6 hours, again the counter-attack launched.
By the British troops.
By the British troops.
Okay.
The position was recaptured.
Yes.
Then there was one person still breathing, unconscious, unrecognizable because of the head injury. He is Havaldar Umrao Singh.
Okay.
And the next, what is around him is the history.
Yes.
He was surrounded by 10 dead Japanese, 7 Japanese critically wounded. This gentleman did not leave his this rod and he was next to his
He
gun.
Beat 10 Japanese to death.
Death. And 7 were critically injured.
Critically injured with that iron rod.
With that iron rod.
And these Japanese were obviously soldiers, they were armed.
They all were armed. They were attacking.
Yes.
And he was the guy who was without any ammunition.
To forget Hawaldar Umrao Singh would be to forget a very important part of our past, of our history.